second story. As you don't know, and as the others know, at the beginning of this year I was in Boston at the MSF conference, and giving a talk, talking about certification, talking about an ecosystem to get certified for such trainer and a migration specialist. And it was a quite reasonable answer to his talk. We made a workshop where some attendees in the workshop, very interesting to do business around LibreOffice, but there was no migration project. No interest from the most public affairs side. There was no need to have an ecosystem around LibreOffice to bring in these services. So that's exactly a chicken egg problem. Or chicken egg dilemma. How do you say chicken or egg dilemma or chicken and egg dilemma? What's the right thing? Oh, you don't even know it, so it's okay. So, what can we do? This was the idea. What can we do to overcome this bang, to have a growth in points, in blank points of the map in the world, to have professional deployments of LibreOffice and even the right ecosystem, a local ecosystem who can support these migrations. So, and what I now want to do is, I thought something about these catalysts I spoke, and I want a little bit to summarize what I think were some catalysts in the German market. Germany has a long history with LibreOffice before OpenOffice and so on. And I was thinking about it, and I will, at the end of this topics or issues, I will ask if Germany is still a role model for it. But the idea is behind this, and we, later we will ask three other people from around the world what they think, what were the catalysts for that. I want to get an idea or discuss some issues of that, what we can do as the certification part of TDF, but also the all members of the TDF to growing up these issues. So Germany, or me, as these are my experiences, I was in contact in the early 2000s with Sun, and my company was perhaps not the first official partner of Sun Microsystems. In these days, where we do some work on StarOffice, afterwards on OpenOffice, we have done some tool developments for migrating automatically from Microsoft Office to StarOffice, and a little bit later to OpenOffice and so on. So we were relatively in the OpenOffice history. Relatively early in these processes involved, and afterwards we have done these work that in Germany the companies, the Star Division, which were behind the Star Office, were relatively known. Some were coming in buying them, so they. There was a relatively important catalyst that Sun was doing something like market development. We can discuss if it was good market development or something like this. They made the decision to open source StarOffice, and they did something like the partner management. Somebody from the knows the guys who were active in there, but they were doing such things. They invite partners every half year to come to Hamburg, where the star division was located, give information, and care about these parties. So I think something like an anchor company, and I know it's a little bit heavy to discuss, but I think in these days, the anchor companies was one of the catalysts for growing up this German ecosystem and getting such migration projects. Last but not least, there were some anchor persons, not only in companies, but also in communities. So we have, in the early days, we have Fodef.
It was an association.
It was an association from German community. We were doing a lot of work to do there. We have done the first conferences in Germany for free office systems. There was a lot of work, and there were some anchor persons in the community, the local community. Perhaps somebody knows Thomas Umwein, one of them, Jacqueline Rahimipur, Florian was one of them, Thorsten, and certainly I forget someone. Yes, there were some others. I hope I don't forget some others. So the issue is one of the second catalyst persons, anchor persons. In person, Gabriele spoke about such things. We are in people business. So, beside that, there were in Germany, especially one, but afterwards a few others, lighthouse projects. Everybody spoke about the city of Munich. You know the history, which is going as time goes by. But in this time, growing up, the ecosystem and the awareness about professional LibreOffice deployments depends on these lighthouse projects, and mainly in the public affairs area. Not so much in the economy, but more in the public affairs. I think this is my impression. We can discuss this. There was another issue. This is something more like a technical issue or a mute in the realm, that there was a need for changing, a need for change, because we have in this time the depression in the ecosystem. We got more and more cost sensitivity. Awareness of the vendor lock-in from Microsoft especially. And there was a very, very, very important issue. It was the developing of the open document format. The document format is a technical driver in this ecosystem which can't underestimate it. Yeah, so this was the situation which were in Germany, and there were a lot of eggs, a lot of migration projects, and a lot of companies who are doing support services and so on. But nowadays, we have to look, we have lost a lot of them. Not just companies who are away doing other things, also projects which are gone, which are migrated back to Microsoft and so on. So what I don't want to discuss here, but are we still alone in Germany for the ecosystem? Or are we perhaps ahead of the history? So could we expect such developments in other areas of the world where the ecosystem is healthy and so on? But this is not the question I think we should discuss now, we should have in mind. And the evolution never stops. The product is going ahead, and we have in the world something like LibreOffice Online. And this is changing things a little bit. We don't talk about any longer about a Linux desktop and so on. So our product is not in combination with Linux, and this brings up some questions. So what I want to do now is to have some other views and to bring in other points of the map world and ask them to tell us what they think the catalysts to bring up these migration projects, to bring up, to grow the community around the ecosystem and so on. I've given them three questions, so I think 3 to 5 minutes for each of you. As you said. Should we begin with Marina? Certainly, Marina. Tell us something about Italian. What was that similar? Another way,
for Italy, probably the catalyst is the CAP, that is the local national law that helped us a lot for the migration, because in this law it's clear that for the public administration is mandatory to evaluate if there are open source alternatives to the veterinary one. So this one is the first way to at least to have a first evaluation. Then on the community side, with Libertaria, we invested a lot in promotion, not only about the office, but also in general about format, open format, open standards, and sometimes when a public administration start to discuss, to search for alternatives, for mainly from saving cost, because this one is the first reason. They try to understand if the alternative is available to manage the document in the same way like Office. So starting from the format is the first way to load the button. Because if the document is provided in in an open format, standard, in theory, is a little bit simple. But it's not enough, because it's also important to organize trainings, because without trainings you can also use OBF as format, but if you are formatting wrong document, the problem is still there. So you need to discuss about styles, for example, or you need to show which are the issue with the document that it's formatted in. We saw documents that were really creative. So this one is another important topic that can be forget. And as ecosystem is important also to interact with the local community, because the local community is the bridge between the foundation and the activities that are done in that specific country. So without real interaction, the risk is that the company that is trying to provide services doesn't know everything that is needed for a good migration. For example, there are companies that are providing services following a protocol that is not the TDF-1. Okay, the TDF-1 maybe it's not the perfect one, but it's tested. And we already know which are the main difficulties. So this one, less or more, is the Italian
way of life.
Yeah.
Thanks, Marina. Simon? Some words about the value of the training?
Okay, so the case of Albania is a little bit different. The country used to be isolated until the 90s, so this was like a main factor for technology in general, but also events related to open source software or open source philosophy to reach out to us quite later than European Western countries or other countries in general. So we started having communities who promote open source software after 2012, where Open Labs was established as an organization, which was also the first organization in our country to do this kind of events. And after that year, we started having a lot of local communities, such as Wikipedia, Nextcloud, Mozilla, and most importantly, also LibreOffice. So in these terms, we don't have a lot of case studies to share where big organizations or big institutions went through this process or through big migrations. And the only one that we can mention currently is the one that which is taking place at the municipality of Tirana. Also, another thing that I can add is the fact that currently there are no companies who offer consultancy or any other kind of service related to migrations to LibreOffice, but also to open source solutions in general.
And so there's a lack of blockchain.
Yeah, right. Exactly. And also about LibreOffice, there are, as far as I know, there are also not any certified professionals yet. So this makes the thing a bit more challenging for us, and we need to look for other success stories through other countries. But we need to also take into consideration the cultural differences in each country, because, for example, Germany can't really be a case study for us, because the countries are quite different in many aspects. So currently we have the migration which is taking place at the municipality, and an important driving force that I can mention which impacted their decision to migrate was the impact of the local community, the fact that you have people here who are strongly promoting using open standards and using open LibreOffice as a replacement to Microsoft Office. The fact that these people are organizing this kind of events or can reach out to the people who are standing behind LibreOffice gives some sort of certainty in order to proceed and take the big decision to migrate, which in the case of an institution is a very important decision because you are taking a lot of responsibility in your shoulders. So basically this is like a general overview and the actual situation in Albania. I hope that in the future when we have more people or maybe hopefully even more companies who operate, maybe there will be even more cases with organizations and not only institutions who go ahead and start using the office.
More chickens and more eggs. Thank you. So Frank, you have 3 minutes. Frank, you have 3 minutes to tell us the Asian track record.
Okay, I say the Chicken problem is very different than every different country. Taiwan is mostly most Asian country. One of the main problems is that people can get proprietary software in a very low price. In a very low price. And that is really the problem. But for this year in Taiwan, this condition is much better. So interestingly, that gave us a chance. So in Taiwan now, actually for almost all the free software related activities, including business activities, they were mostly driven by community. And the catalyst would be government. In nearly 20 years before, our government bounced once, but that time failed because the business part didn't catch it, and they made a big mistake because those companies that attended at that time, they just want to get benefit from it, but don't want to dig it. That problem still exists in Taiwan now. And the second is, of course, at that time, the whole environment, including at that time, OpenOffice is not mature enough. The desktop is not mature enough. But now, recent years, we have a very good chance because for the software part, we have a very good software now. And I just say that for the low price providers for the program, it's much better in Taiwan now. So many companies, many governments now suffer from the licensing. And finally, right now is the government launched the, it's an engine. It provides both radio and sticks. And what community do is something like steering gear. We have them to fix the directions. And then, this time, I have already successfully that our government invest our local companies, local developers, to develop to customize LibreOffice, provide legal services, and they are feedback to upstream now. So I think I'm optimistic in the condition of Taiwan because we are now having a small but looks like good ecosystem. Of course, we have chicken first. That's now we have a big migration project in whole Taiwan. Just those small units call me and I will give them, especially to communicate with them. And communication is a very important part. That's driven by community. But then, now, those other business, those other companies that would join in, I would insist that, yes, of course, you can join in, but remember the feedback. You cannot just get but without giving in. So I think that's the condition so far.
Okay. Thank you. So, Marina, I have 1 minute of your time. So, we have now heard from four different local persons around the world, and what we should learn out of this, and this is the overwhelming solution of how getting flank points on the map growing up is, it's all about community. It's growing the community. It's all about having persons there. It's all about bringing from the present community, bringing up all these speeds, all these catalysts to other points, traveling, Gabriela mentioned, traveling to them, give a talk, give a speech, give a workshop. But target should be to have locals growing up with, because they understand the culture of the government, of the people, and so on. And if you have anchor persons there, like you, thank you for your talk, then we can overcome these chicken and egg dilemma for the ecosystem and the professional development. This was my idea, my thoughts behind this talk, and remember that this was the third talk for growing up all around the LibreOffice. I repeat, Michael Meeks with thoughts about product marketing. checking ag professional developments and ecosystem, and all have the same answer. It's we have to do it. We have to go there, we have to overcome these language issues and so on, cultural issues, and bringing up and growing locals.